Good morning, everyone. This is Dr. Alakesh Singh, MDS second year student from Department of Conservative Dentistry and Endodontics. Today, I am going to take seminar on the topic of endodontic and orthodontic relationship. So, these are my content, introduction part, effect of orthodontics on the tooth being moved, endodontic and orthodontic combined therapy, like basic periodontal principle for forced eruption, basic endodontic principle for forced eruption, basic orthodontic principle for tooth movement, forced eruptional criteria, tooth lacking a clinical crown and tooth with intact crown. So coming to the introduction part, effects of orthodontics on the tooth being moved are orthodontics as a etiological agent for endodontics, like resorptive defect, necessary monitoring by the orthodontics and the general dentistian, and treating the teeth after the orthodontic treatment is needed, and treating teeth during the orthodontic treatment endodontic purpose is needed. So whenever during the orthodontic treatment and after orthodontic treatment also, endodontic therapy should needed some cases. So in that case, we can see orthodontics as a etiological agent for endodontic. We can see that after orthodontic placement, root resorption and bone loss was there present because of excessive apical force and root rotation. That time we should need restoration of the existing tooth and we have to do the root canal treatment. So we can see that first picture, we can see that there are bone loss and periapical lesion in the x-ray. After obturation, the bony lesion is resolved and more bone formation we can see. And after later period of time, the healing take place and sufficient bone is formed in the apical portion of the root canal treated tooth. So in the case of resorptive defect, we can see that first picture, because of orthodontic treatment, there are internal resorption, the ballooning effect of into the canal we can see. So first phases we are using the calcium hydroxide. Second diagram we can see that calcium hydroxide or metaprex intracanal dressing is given for 21 days. After that, we can see that third picture we are using by MTA and GP, we are obturating the resorptive defect, and we are using the GP, we are manipulate the defect of the resorptive portion which done because of orthodontic purpose. So coming to the necessary monitoring by the orthodontics and the general dentist, and treating the tooth after endodontic therapy, is we can see that there are bone loss and the periapical huge lesion, and after that we are using the endodontic because we already restored the tooth, and after that because of orthodontic tooth movement and tooth force, that after orthodontic treatment we can see that the apical portion of the root is resolved and more GP is exposed in the apical portion. So what we have to need, we have to retreatment of the root canal, RCT have to done, and we have to place the MTA and we have to seal the apical portion and we have to retreatment of the canal to survive the tooth. So coming to the treated teeth during the orthodontic treatment, we can see that whenever orthodontic wear is placed, that time more bone loss is there and the central incisor is rotated and more bone loss was there. So we are endodontics has planned for root canal treatment of the central incisor, and after central incisor they placed post and core and have to give the crown. We have to remove the crown first because in that x-ray we can see that crown is visible. And after orthodontic treatment, it's again bone formation was take place. So endodontic orthodontic combined therapy is advanced, carries traumatic destruction of the clinical crown, lateral root perforation, external and internal root resorption near alveolar crest, and overt jealous tooth preparation. Basic periodontal principle of a forced eruption, basic endodontical principle for forced eruption, basic orthodontic principle for tooth movement. So basic principle For forced eruption, we can see the biological width. The sulcus depth is 0.6 mm, epithelial attachment is 0.97, and connective tissue is 1.07 mm. So biological width we can see is 2.04 mm. So maintenance the health and integrity of the biological width. A restoration that impinge on the biological width will result in periodontal disease. So under control of orthodontic folds, the biological width of the gingival tissue moves with the tooth. In the presence of periodontal disease, the tooth movement may contribute the depending on the existing osseous defect. So when osseous surgery is completed on an anterior teeth, the scalloped gingival form contributes to the difficulty in obtaining a cosmetic result. Exposing adequate sound tooth structure by periodontal surgery alone the lead to shorter clinical route and a larger clinical crown. We can see that in the diagram. So coming to the basic endodontic principle for forced eruption, endodontic treatment should be completed prior to the initiation of tooth movement. If endodontic therapy becomes necessary after initiation of tooth movement, initially pulp is excreted, canal sealed, and treatment completed after the tooth movement is totally done. Teeth with loss or destruction of clinical crown must have endodontical therapy complete prior to the tooth movement. And if it is needed posterior core, we have to do the same. Basic orthodontic principle for tooth movements are an estimate of the amount of attachment apertures remaining at the completion of the tooth movement must be made, and teeth must have sufficient radicular attachment to the assist in the support of multilateral restoration or maintain the individual integrity. Adequate anchorage must be available to produce only the movement of the specifically required. No tooth movement to be done unless the retention and stabilization phase has been fully planned. So bicuspidation or a hemisection and orthodontics. In that case, whenever hemisection is needed, any cases, that time we have to do the hemisection case, and we have to split the molar into a two premolar, and we have to place a loop into a defective. We have to pass the wear without attachment whenever needed, and we have to attach the wear where the force is eliminated more apically in the good root. Forced eruption. Coming to the forced eruption, offer a method of treatment of the tooth fractured close to the alveolar crest. Expose additional sound tooth structure and discrease. The need for a surgical procedure is lateral needed. Also called as control orthodontic extrusion, orthodontic eruption, vertical extrusion, assisted eruption. It is given by Hutterson in 1970 and in Bugs. So tooth movement can be obtained with removable or fixed orthodontic appliances. Forced eruption is advocated for treating the transverse root fracture and coronal fracture, root caries, external resorption, iatrogenic perforation as the alternative therapy of a infrabony pocket, slowing extraction of a tooth like radiation therapy. Forced eruption, there are four identified phases: case selection and root preparation, application of force, stabilization, and file and reconstruction. Endodontic, orthodontic, periodontic, and aesthetic principle are utilized in forced eruption therapy. So how will select the case? So root trauma favorable and unfavorable. If periodontal attachment is there, the fracture line in between the CG level, then it is comes under favorable. If the root portion, the fracture line is below the crestal level or bony level, it is, the case is unfavorable. So coming to the root length, if 1:1 root and crown ratio is there, then it's favorable case, and unfavorable, it is less, root is, crown and root ratio is more less than 1:1, then it is unfavorable. So internal pulp form is available is when the internal pulp width is more in 1/3 area, it is favorable. If the more pulpal form, internal pulpal form is affected, then it is unfavorable. Root form available, zone of eruption is needed. If zone of eruption is more into the attachment level, it is favorable. It is less, it is unfavorable condition. So root health is favorable in that case, because of no periapical lesion and sufficient bone we can see. And in unfavorable case, we can see that a huge periapical lesion and lateral opening also infected by lateral microorganism deposition from the bone and periodontium. So coming to the case selection criteria, adjacent tooth we have to see, occlusion we have to check, overbite, overjet we have to check, tooth value, how many tooth is left is needed, aesthetic zone, age history we have to see, application of force, when hooks are used they must be aligned over the long axis of the tooth. In both fixed and removable appliance, a force of 25 to 30 gram are needed, it's advisable. Applied in the line of the long axis of the tooth, patients are examined on a weekly basis to assure the compliance and the movement of the tooth. Stabilization, the tooth must be stabilized, allow for remolding of the periodontium aperture and prevent the relapse. And generally stabilization is for 4 weeks for every millimeter of a movement, and final reconstruction is done by regrettal of the technique, the biological which should be maintained completely. The case is involves the following traditional technique for post and core fabrication and crown placement. So tooth lacking of a clinical crown, and in that condition endodontic therapy is completely immediately done. Post space of adequate width and length is provided by space, pore space creation by GG drills, and control of gingival inflammation by curettage is completed prior to the tooth movement. 0.030 to 0.036 inch SS wire having a loop bend is fit slungly to the pore space. Wire is cemented into the canal with the temporary cement. Direct bonded orthodontic bracket are placed on a sufficient number of tooth on the both side of the tooth to be erupted for adequate anchorage. Rigid 0.016 inch wire is ligated into the bracket, and an elastic laser cord is tied from the wire to cemented post. The tooth is moved slowly into the position over a period of 4 to 6 weeks. So in that case we can see that loop is used, and that 1.016 loop is bracket is tightened with the ligature wire into the post, and after that selective eruption, tooth with intact crown, and selective eruption is forced eruption is done. So coming to the fixed device, orthodontic bracket are used, orthodontic bracket button and elastic are used, embedded rod and root hook and elastics are used, temporary bridge and root hook and elastics are used. Removable device are embedded rod in a acrylic, root hook and elastics are used. Hollis democryptive spring and root hooks are used, embedded button and root hooks and elastics are used. So some frequent question answer was, does orthodontic treatment tooth movement have impact on viability of the dental pulp? So Schelzler and Blender in 1984, they gave that pulpal injury occurs as a during rapid movement which is due to alteration of the blood vessels. Alteration in pulpal vasculature will result in increased deposition of the reparative dentin along with concurrent increase of dystrophic mineralization. In Doherty in 1968, they caused that orthodontic tooth movement can obliteration of the pulpal paste. In Brunsand et al. In 1974, study shows that clinical tooth may have altered the sensation to the stimuli which has direct impact to the, on the metabolism of the pulp tissue. Second question is apical root resorption, they may occur during orthodontic treatment, the same on tooth with vital pulp as on root canal treat to tail, means transdent in 1988 and enteric in 1984, 5 to 10 years after orthodontic treatment, 42.3% of maxillary central incisor and 38.5% of lateral incisor undergone apical resorption. So, apical root resorption is seen after orthodontic treatment. Overall incident was 28.8% for orthodontic treated tooth compared to 3.8% of control tired. And Lavender and Malmegran in 1988, tooth with blunt and pipette shaped root of maxillary central incisor were greater risks of apical resorption. What is the status of resorption in the tooth with vital pulp versus the tooth with RCT? Stamden in 1948 criticized RCT, claimed that devitalized root as a foreign body causing a chronic irritation and root resorption. And Hunterson and Young in 1955 evaluated the root structure of a monkey teeth with a vital and non-vital pulp following orthodontic treatment and conclude that these tooth showed no foreign body reaction and root resorption observed was similar in both vital and root canal treated tooth. If root filled teeth were subjected to resorption phenomenon, what will happen to filling material? Hamilton and Gutman in 1999, tooth may resorb and exfoliate and filling material removed with tooth. Tooth may resorb and exfoliate and filling material left into the bone, and tooth may resorb exposing filling material, and subsequently the resorption seizes the filling material producing beyond a new pedial space and lamina dura may form in approximation of the filling material. Can endodontically treated tooth move orthodontically as readily as non-endodontically treated? Week where 1955, Mattison 1983 and Hunter 1990 and Mah 1996, and they gave that endodontically treated tooth can be moved readily for the same distance as the teeth with vital pulp. Can teeth that has been managed with surgical endodontic procedure be moved orthodontically? Baranowski in 1969 assessed dog teeth with RCT and previously periodontal surgeries. They were subjected to that early application of orthodontic force. He concluded that the healing was completely delayed in tooth with RCT and root end rejection. So, conclusion is the expand of role of endodontic into more phase of dental treatment is illustrated by the awareness of relation with other branches like periodontics, orthodontics, etc. There are two major areas where endodontics and orthodontics share common ground. One is etiological, and because of orthodontic treatment affect the tooth being moved and some of the response may notate into the pulp tissue. And the other area involves combined therapy where the orthodontic treatment is necessary to gain a desirable endodontic result like crown lengthening, etc. These are my reference. Thank you.